In our previous video, we talked about the most effective ways to collect odor from different places that it will arise in your facility. But once it's all collected and you've got it in your ducting, it needs to go somewhere before it goes out into the world. We can't release that raw odor. So in this section, we'll talk about what are some of the different technologies you can use to treat that odor once it's collected. So our main goals in our odor treatment step are to remove the odor from the gas phase and into an aqueous or a solid phase, so leaving our clean air to go off into the environment again. And or we want to destroy, usually oxidize, the odor compounds. Some technologies will just capture it and then dispose of the sorbent, but it's always better if you can treat that compound as well, so it's not going to produce odor problems down the line. And there's a number of technologies that do this, capturing and or destroying that odor. These are aqueous dissolution, solid adsorption, chemical, biological, and thermal oxidation. We'll talk about each one of these. Our first technology is a wet scrubber. So this is one of those aqueous dissolution technology. And a wet scrubber is all about using a scrubbent, which is an aqueous solvent that has been designed to absorb odor compounds from the airstream. And to have the wet scrubber work really well, you need to have really good mass transfer between your air that you want to treat and the scrubbent. And this is accomplished in one of two ways. One is to spray the scrubbent into the air, so you have all these little droplets that are contacting the air on all sides. And that's shown on the right side here with this atomized mist scrubber. And then the other approach is to use a solid packing media. And so it's like little ceramic particles, or sometimes they're different engineered plastic shapes. And the scrubbent is sprayed over them, and then it kind of drips down through them, and then the air flows up through them, and then we have all these different surfaces where they can contact and dissolve. So the scrubbent will be pulling our odor compounds out of the air. The treated air is coming off, and then the spent scrubbent is going to be full of all these odor compounds. Some scrubbents will actually destroy the odor compounds as well. For example, if you use bleach, sodium hypochlorite, that's actually going to be oxidizing the compounds. Whereas other scrubbents, you might just use it until it's saturated, and then you'll send it off to be disposed of elsewhere. A second technology is biofiltration. So this is a biological oxidation technology. And one of the key advantages of a biofilter is because it's a living organism, it keeps itself alive and you don't have to do a lot of maintenance to it, like with a wet scrubber where you might have to be regenerating or disposing of the scrubbent. The biofilter, if kept happy, will just keep growing more microbes and just keep living. So how the biofilter works is you have some media that your microbes are going to be living on, and then they have water sprayed over them to keep your microbes happy, as well as to help dissolve some of those odor compounds. And as you're passing air through the biofilter, it's going to dry it out. So that's why you need to be kind of continually supplying water to make sure everything is nice and moist, your microbes are happy, and you have water available to dissolve your odor compounds. So kind of similar to the packed bed wet scrubber, the biofilter is going to provide a high surface area between these wet media particles and the process air coming through. The process air is going to dissolve into the water on these particles, and then the microbes that are sitting there are going to take those odor compounds and metabolize them and produce oxidized products such as carbon dioxide that are not going to be odorous, and those will be able to come out the system at the end. There are more high-tech and more low-tech options of biofilters. On the left is a more low-tech one, which is literally just a pile of wood chips would be the media over a distribution pipe that's bringing the odorous air in, and then there's some nozzles to help keep it wet. So this would just look like a windrow with kind of positive aeration, but it's specifically there to keep growing those microbes that are going to eat up your odor compounds. There's also more high-tech looking ones, like the one on the right. This one is fully enclosed. This one has a little blower and a stack on it. There's ones with way, way higher stacks, like 30 meters and more. This is just a baby one. But this system is just a little bit easier to control because it's all enclosed. It's easier to monitor and change the temperature and moisture and things like that. And it might use a little bit more high-tech media than wood chips. These are some different ceramic media shown here that are specifically engineered to provide good surfaces for microbes to live on, as well as for that water to flow over and be dissolving those odor compounds that are coming through the system. So biofilters are the types of systems that I've seen most commonly applied in Ontario, and they just tend to be pretty reliable, pretty low cost systems, but you do have to keep the bugs happy or else they'll die and stop treating your odor. Carbon adsorption, something you've probably seen in a lot of fields, different air pollution control, water treatments. Carbon is just very good at absorbing a large variety of particles, and that applies to odor compounds very well. You can actually buy consumer carbon adsorbents that you can put in your closet to help absorb shoe smells and smoke smells and things like that. So it's just the same principle. Very similar to the packed bed adsorber for the wet scrubber, only this we don't need water. The carbon is going to do the job itself in the solid form. You're going to blow your odorous air through. You're going to have really high surface area because you're using granulated or powdered carbon. And then at a certain point, your carbon's just going to become saturated and it will need to be regenerated or replaced. So pretty straightforward technology, pretty widely applied, and really takes advantage of carbon's very good ability to adsorb all types of different organics. Another technology is regenerative thermal oxidation. And this is essentially just burning the odor compounds that are present in our odorous air and then having them come out in an oxidized form, just like they would be from a biofilter. It's just using a thermal reaction instead of a biological reaction. So how this works is it's full of a solid media that is going to retain the heat, and then there's a little bit of fuel added to sustain a flame, and then whatever air comes in is going to both provide the oxygen for the flame as well as anything that's able to combust within the odor compounds will be combusted as well. Now, if you had a process that required air for a combustion process, like a solid waste incinerator or a biogas boiler, you could also send your treatment air to that system and have it be used there. You'd use a regenerative thermal oxidizer where you didn't already have a combustion process happening and you wanted to do combustion in the most efficient way possible. The last thing that I'll mention on odor is an odor treatment method that you can use if you have not been able to contain your odor and treat it in one of the treatment systems that we just looked at, and those are misting systems. So mists can contain a solvent, usually water, and then a compound that would adsorb, oxidize, or mask the odors, or a blend of some of these. And these are typically dispersed in a distributed way through the environment. Some examples shown in the pictures here are along fence lines, throughout a whole building area, around doors, anywhere where odor could be moving off-site or moving out of the area it's supposed to be controlled into. And this is typically used where you're not able to address odor with some of the other methods. As I mentioned, it's always better to address odor closest to the point where it's being created. But if it gets off and you need to do something about it, you're having complaints and things like that, then these are some systems that you can also use to try and keep it under control as it moves out of your building and off your site. Misting systems are very effective at distributed odor sources where it's really hard to collect from a single point. So a landfill, for example, or a wastewater treatment plant with all these big outdoor tanks, these are types of places that will apply misting systems.